Hello everybody, and welcome back to another Euro Truck Simulator 2. I don't think we're finished the load that we're on. You find out now. Oh, we did. We did deliver. World map. Are we in Cambridge? We are. Yeah, okay. So we're in Cambridge. That's good. Let's go and see what the freight market is looking like. And where do I want to go? Well, let's look at where the money is. There's 12 grand to go to Thessalonica with a trailer. And 11 to go to Casablanca again, which is the same route we came out of, but not quite as far as Rabat. Oh no, it is. It's farther than Rabat. The Nixtaza, I don't have no those places. And that's a tank again, which is full of hot chemicals. Hot chemicals. It is an ADR class 2 and standard delivery. But this pays better and it is quite a drive. Yeah, it's a really good drive because we have to drive to Scotland in order to pick it up. Let's just click on Cambridge and do it the sensible way, shall we? This is down to Loania. I never heard of that either. And we end up taking Ancona to Igoumenitsa. And I can't speak. Anyway, that's worth 5 grand. So it's the best paying job there by a long measure. But it's just sawdust panels. So I guess that's what we're doing. We're coming into Belgium, down through Luxembourg, touching off France, hopping across Switzerland. Might be some interesting driving there. Okay, let's do that. I am following the money, of course. No surprise there. I've been doing that all along. So here we are in our truck, and yeah, things are good. If we pop outside, we're parked up here. I think we dropped off there, but that's all empty. So let's get a start going on here, and we need to change our gear system. We've got forward movement, so we are good. And is it here? I don't think it is here, but let's have a look. See, it is here too. Enter. Yeah, that's it. It's behind us. A green flag. Do you see a green flag? It's not on that side, so it must be over here. Oh, there it is. Just bring it around here quite hard. Can get it on there. Should have seen that earlier, shouldn't I? But anyway, we're loaded and we are away. I mean, that's a load, it's a container trailer with a small container on it, so it's just doesn't look so pretty. Doesn't look so pretty. Right, so it's out the gate and to the left. We are in England, so we have to drive on the left. Might as well indicate as well. I'm going to stop here for a moment and come back, because I've just worked out that my track IOR is a bit mad. So Apologies about this, I'm back in a moment. And we're back into traffic. And all is good. But I tell you, sometimes when I change my track IOR, it's a bit crazy. And there's quite a bit of traffic here, so I'm wondering if it makes sense to try and get out the other way. Because they're only going to let about three cars out, and it's filling here, so... Are you going to let me out there, Land Rover? I doubt you are. No, you're not. We're going to drive in front of me. I've got quite a bit to go still. The green car is not going to let me out either. I'm kind of pushing it here now a little bit, I know, but... I want to get out. Hey, you pesky, pesky, pesky person. Where is the honor? Wow. Kind of almost a case of just nudging a little more forward there, isn't there? Although I'm going to get out now in front of this, but will I? 2, 3... No, I won't. Frick, because the car's going to be right under me. I won't be able to go any further. And I've caused a crash. Yeah. That was a bit bad. That was bad. That was impatient. And now I need to back up or otherwise he won't move. Maybe I can back up and get past him here. No, he's gonna move. The lorry is going to stop and let me go because he has no choice. Yeah. Very bad. Very, very, very bad indeed. Really, really, very bad. I don't sound very upset about that, do I? I guess I should be, because it is somewhat against my plans to have clean runs. But anyway, you may notice that in this episode I've brought my steering position, or my view position, a little over the wheel, over the steering wheel. Long lane here too. It's actually proving to be quite nice. I do need to slow down my track IOR a little bit in the middle zone, because I can kind of flick from one window to the other a little too much. It's a bit too fast. Just this view that, if you will, that is this, the width of the steering wheel and maybe the GPS console. It's just a little too flicky. But I think it has a future, this view. Kind of feels good. Feels quite comfortable, actually. And it's probably quite realistic as well. When you kind of sit in your car, I was thinking about this the other day, and you sit in the car, you don't have a full view of your steering wheel like that. You're actually not really consciously noticing the full wheel at all. Your concentration is out the window, and your peripheral vision is picking up the console and the top of the steering wheel and whatnot. And I think it's even more so when you're in a lorry, and certainly in a bus anyway, because their steering wheel is It's quite a bit flatter, isn't it? So, that's the new plan anyway, and so far, me liking it. Plus it forces me to actually turn my head to get over to that outside wing mirror, and that enhances my sense of immersion a little bit, because I'm only sitting at a desk here like anybody else. Right, we're out. M11, and we're heading south. So that's it. It's the what day is it anyway? It's Tuesday in the game, 11:15 in the morning. We have 5.5 hours of driving. And we have 42 hours of driving to our destination total, with 88 hours of a window. So we're fuel is pretty okay. We're just under half. And yeah, 27,000 on the clock already. What's the distance on this one? 2,500. So we'll be very close to 30 by the time we're done. We won't be at 30 though, but we'll be at 30 on the next one. So that's kind of interesting. 30,000, quite quickly. I know, the game accelerates things and compresses time and screws around with the reality settings, but still quite a number. Third of a way towards my 100,000 on the Odo. If I stick with that plan or not, I don't know, but at the moment obviously I'm sticking with it. Need to earn enough dough to be able to purchase the next truck and hire a driver as well, and I'll hand over this truck to them. That's my current plan, because you know I haven't hired any drivers yet. I'm thinking to myself, in the real world you wouldn't just go out and do that. And I haven't taken out a bank loan either, which is something that is common to most of my simulation gameplay. It's not exclusive, but I haven't taken out any bank loan with Farming Simulator 2013, although I inherited a bank loan when you start the game, and that kind of explains, I suppose, some of the machinery that you have, which I sold back for a loss in order to afford me to buy other machinery. But anyway, all of that is on my Farming Simulator 2013 career. If you're interested in that, you're welcome to go and check it out. I haven't started my air hauler career yet, because I'm not set up for flying at the moment, and I'm looking forward to getting back to that. But I think in the air hauler career I do have a loan as well. But in Euro Truck Simulator 2 I do not. And my intention is to not have a loan. The other thing that I need to remember is that I want to drive at 80. You know, this is maybe a stupid idea, I'm not sure. Well, actually, I'm probably sure it is a stupid idea, but I do want to drive at 80 a little bit more, to mostly just manage the... Oh, I just yawned again. Every time I get into this game, I yawn. And I wasn't tired beforehand. And that's not the first time I've said that, and it probably won't be the last, so... Sorry if you're bored of me saying that, but... what was I saying anyway? Yeah, I kind of want to get the scheduling and the arrival for delivery. I want to get that a little bit better. touching off of, you know, plus or minus a day is a little bit too open. I'd, you know, if I have a morning window, I'd like to get there the night before. But it would be the night before, as opposed to 2 days before. And I think in an earlier video I was talking about this, and the example that I gave was backwards. And I picked up on that afterwards. But anyway. I said Tuesday and then delivery on Wednesday, it wouldn't work, and well, of course it wouldn't, you'd be late. I meant to say plan for Wednesday, but you arrive on Tuesday, and that's nearly as bad because you're so early they're still not ready for you. If I have, for example, a 10 o'clock in the morning delivery window, say on a Wednesday, I think it's okay if I'm getting to the location on the Tuesday evening, finding a place to park up and, you know, turn up at the yard to offload at 10 the following morning. But I don't think that it's necessarily cool if I'm turning up on Monday evening, or Monday afternoon. In some cases I am, or even on Tuesday morning. That's a little too early. The other component is probably not a component, and I don't need to do the experiment to find out. I should be able to just ask and be told, but I'm wondering if doing 80 is a little more gentle on my repair bills. But to be honest with you, I'm going to be going for a long time before I'm able to truly determine that. So yeah. I'm constantly tweaking and trying out things, and I'm liking this view, but I need to edit my profile rather significantly, so I'll probably try and do that before the next installment, the next episode. And I'll also try and work out why I'm yawning at like 2 yawns a minute at the moment. And apologizing to anybody who's offended by my yawning. Well, that's overdoing it, sorry. Now I apologize for apologizing for something that isn't something I should apologize for. God, stop it. But I genuinely, you know, don't want to be just yawning on my videos. I don't think it's terribly polite. Right, oh, so are we, what are we doing? Are we taking a boat here? Or if we're within the SES version of taking a boat, we're just driving to a car park and then appearing in the car park at the other side. As I said in my last video, could they not have just gone that little bit extra? No. But that's something I'm sure they will work on. I could classify that as one of those slight improvements that once you set about doing it properly, you'll probably command somebody's time for quite a while in order to get it done right. An SES based on listening to their CEO and head dude, they're not much in for taking shortcuts. They're the kind of let's do it right or let's not do it at all kind of folks, and quite a lot to be said for that, to be honest with you. It's good. Not sure about that line there. In fact, I'm pretty sure it's not accurate. I'm pretty sure it's wrong. I don't think that there's a yield on a junction for me. In that scenario, I think the yield is on the junction of that of the T of the car coming out. Just checking that I have my lights on, and I do. The other advantage here is that you have a much clearer view of the dash in the truck here. all of it, really. Not just the gauges and so on. It's a superior view, I think, in every regard. And it's taken me, what are we on, 23 or 24 episodes to work it out. But anyway, I was never the fastest. Sometimes that's a good thing. That's understood by some and not by others, I suppose. The White Cliffs of, where'd you call it? Dover. I'm over there. And we must be going down to the channel then, as I call it, the Channel Tunnel, linking the island of Great Britain with the bigger landmass that is the European mainland, or as we in Ireland say, over there. Did it just have a darkness coming in? I think there's a build-up of weather. Oh, there is too, look. Could be raining water up here in no time. He says. That just tells you how good I am. And we need to hit the brakes here now on a wet road, because rolling it in gentle to a stop. I'm gonna stick on the doubles, because I don't know what these people are doing. Now, I can flash him, but he won't do a thing. Oh yes, he will. Oh, he had a car in front as well, which wasn't helping. But, okay. We got there. And there's loads of either... No, that's lightning. Or car flashes, I can't tell which. Right, so the inclement weather has caught up with us in Blighty. Crikey. I have to say that the rainstorms here are quite a bit more mainland Europe-esque than they are Islander-like. Not that you don't have rain and thunder in England and Ireland, or Britain and Ireland, but they're pretty sudden and heavy when they do hit here, and that is quite indicative of your weather, you know, in the middle of Europe. Just comes up and dumps. I think I can go down here, and I think I can go down here ahead of this guy, so. I shall. Ooh, there, Jenny. I was far enough away, but I didn't look like I was still. The other thing to would be cool is to be able to drive into here. We have the entry carriage, which is this one. In the real world, you would follow in LKW all the way up to the front, unless you're the last one. It's a knack to get it right. I'm a little over, and my head is getting wet. And we'll call that. Oh, don't want to do that. Don't want to do that. We'll call that loaded. So, off with us. And it's still raining across the other side of the channel. How about that? The same weather storm, half an hour later, is still going. I'm not sure if that's 100% believable. Although, it's... yeah, why wouldn't it be? What I don't know is how these trucks get off this train, because there's no exit trailer. Or carriage, or whatever it's called on the front. A little detail that's missing there, methinks. Or maybe it's not. Maybe I just don't understand how it works. We don't understand. What be going on there? I don't know why I do stupid English accents every so often. But, I'll use my usual defense. I only take this out of people I quite like. So, that's basically everybody. I don't really dislike anybody. Apart from lazy people. Although I don't really have the right to say that because I have my moments as well. I'm very middle of the road today. I was really annoyed yesterday. Not yesterday, the other day. I was I'd had a long old day, but I hopped on here. Episode 23, I believe, was it? And at the end of my drive, I was a chill dude. Everything was awesome. ETS2 can make your life more relaxed. How about that? That's true. Well, for me it is anyway. I did try Train Simulator when I was a bit tired once. I'm not really at the stage with Train Simulator that I'm on top of it yet. Like I'm on top of Euro Truck Simulator as I drive into red cars or bollards or lampposts or whatever other stupid things I do. But I'm really behind the curve on Train Simulator thing. I'm getting it though. The last run I did represented rather significant improvement overall, I'd like to think. Still not perfect, but damn, not too bad. You're good to go and I'm not blocking your rear view. All you've got to do is go. And I'm good to go as well now. So here we go. Yeah, it's really about timing and just, you know, keeping on. I'm not sure how far my career is going to go with Train Simulator, to be honest. But don't read into that as a you know, some kind of a, oh, he's going to quit. Because I'm not. It does, however, require the purchasing of a lot of downloads if you want to use, you know, DLCs. I think I'm going to troll some of the forums for a while and identify some of the Steam Workshop offerings and pick the better ones from there. And I don't think I'll get into building stuff myself, although maybe I would. I will say this though, some of the degrees of you know, fidelity of the models are just fantastic. The Ice 2 train, you know, the brushed steel door handles are almost realistic. You know, the best of this game is fantastic, but at the same point in time, you're not fooled for very long. And to be honest with you, you're not fooled in Train Simulator for very long either. But when I did see the door handles on that ice train, the Ice 2, that comes standard with the main game, I was thinking to myself, holy cow, you know, FPS killer, but nice eye candy. Do it again, give me more. How much time do I have? I have 2 hours, and I have a station coming up. I'm just trying to work out what I should do. I'm going to come in here and have a look at the map. That's what I'm going to do. I don't need fuel anyway. I'll take my chances for now without fuel. I can get it a little bit later. But I believe this is the right decision to make. So we'll just run it up here and do a check of the map by hitting M. And yeah, I could go into Lille, but there's no fuel stations in the cities here. If I go in there and come out, I suppose I'll pick up whatever that question mark is. And there is no fuel until I get out onto the A7 out here, which is a long way away. But I'm not under fuel. I'm not under fuel pressure. I'm under time pressure. And not really heavily under pressure either. It took so long to do that. It wasn't that long. Yeah. I think I'm going to stop here. I'm going to take a rest and call this video a video. Or an installment or an episode. I'm going to play around with my track IR just a little bit. Just dead zone a little bit in the middle. Or slow it down. And then I'll be back. So until then, as usual, go handy.